afternoon, and then three. Just before we begin, if you could refer Sean.
Sean.
His niece, Brenda, is here with us, and she may give an introduction to Sean's life. There's many people who really don't know a lot about him. We know we have it here in Ostella, and those who get to Zimbabwe know what he has done there. But there are people from New Zealand watching, from South Africa, from Zimbabwe, from the United States, and from England, as well as Ireland, watching this on that day. So, Brenda.
Fathers, brothers, family, friends, and neighbors, it was once said that Sean was present in the ceremony when he woke up on the morning of his wedding, and that was how he greeted each morning. Father Sean was different, and to all of those who were lucky enough to know him and were being his presence, knew how lucky they were. His symbol, the butterfly, was a wonderful representation of him, fluttery and colorful, full of life, leaving an impression on all that comes across it. Many people, when the time has come at the end of life, speak of all the things they wanted to do and didn't get done. Not Father Sean. He had nothing to add, he had nothing to say. He had done and said everything he wanted to do. If we were all so lucky. Father Sean was one of eight brothers and sisters, Willie, Nancy, Mickey, Paddy, Frank, Stella, and Jimmy, born to Anne and Dominic and Dee on the 30th of the 12th, 1924, on the beautiful shores of Loch Arran. Time to unheart, at the age of 11, when Eric Pickney, potatoes, in frozen soil, he decided that education was the way to go, and so he applied and won a scholarship grant to Summerhill College in Sligo. From there he joined an accountancy firm guided by his uncle in Dublin. Father Sean soon realised that numbers were not very exciting to him and started to sit at a desk in the institution. Without conversing with anybody, Father Sean went down to Red Lines and joined the army as you do. There he led a wonderful life that really suited him. He loved the regiment, the timekeeping, the discipline, and army life in general. He loved Dublin and the Curragh and football and dance halls, and we all know his amazing affection for dancing and singing. He loved the uniform and wore it everywhere. He wore it home from every visit, and those shoes were shone by Granny, no doubt, for all the local dances he went to with his brothers and sisters. During this time, he felt a calling from the Holy Spirit to join the priesthood. He has often spoken the whole way through his life about the kindness of the Holy Spirit to him, guiding him through life. In true Father Sean fashion, to spend some time thinking about it, he decided to leave the army and took on a huge journey with his brother Willie on two motorcycles across Europe. They had a magical time when the whole world opened up at their feet, and something about the freedom they experienced would change their lives forever. Willie returned home with the bikes while Father Sean stayed on tour by foot, learning the languages of the country as he went. He would sleep in hay sheds, barns, and was often met by the kindness of people who gave him a hot meal and a bed. He would often speak, though, with gusto about being ran out of a monastery by a brother with two sticks roaring at him. Sean became fluent in Latin, French, Spanish, and Italian, and learned each country's history along the way. When he returned, guided by the Holy Spirit, he approached some ordinations, but unfortunately, as he was now in his late 20s, he was deemed too old to join. His heart was with the Franciscans, and after a few attempts, they gracefully accepted him, and so began the life of his dreams. He entered the novitiate in Killarney in September 1952, and studied in Loughborough University, Louvain, and Rome, where he was proudly ordained to the priesthood in Rome in 1959. He said himself, speaking, he went to Rhodesia in 1960. He said himself in 1960, I was into being with the people under a tree of the Bible. That's where I wanted to be, and that's where I was, and where I was mostly found. I was into freedom in a big way, and that was one of the reasons I went to Rhodesia. I thought the whole place would be free there. We shook hands with the locals and they told us that the gates of great freedom and was a gesture of acceptance. We met everybody with song and dance. I had time then to sit with the old fellows under the trees telling stories and drinking homemade beer. I learned my best Shona language with them and the beer helped tremendously. Shona was one of the most outstanding Christian pioneers of the Franciscan mission. He went on to spend 43 years in Zimbabwe serving people with extraordinary dedication and loving enthusiasm. In 2003, for health reasons, he had to return to Ireland. He said it was his painful death. But the friary, Franciscan Friary, is a place of hospitality and welcome for all of those who seek peace and reconciliation, and Father Sean certainly received that. He said Mass, offered counselling and spiritual direction, as well as being available to anybody who called to the friary. He was so comfortable here in Ostara. He would walk the stunning sand, breathe in the invigorating Atlantic air, and soak up the incredible views of the crashing waves of the bubble fiery. The people here welcomed him with open arms. He told me, "I've been searching for somewhere to heal myself, and I find the kindness of Ostara here the very best way." He said in Ostara, "Kindness spreads like sunshine into people's lives, regardless of the weather." Your kindness and love helped him reach the great age of 97 years young. Himself and Father Sean spoke in the last few weeks, and he just wanted to say a few simple words to you all before he left. So Father's friends, families, neighbours, and everyone who knew him, from Father Sean: "I loved my life. I was blessed to know you all. You have given me strength and encouragement, and for all of that I am truly grateful. I hope that someday we cross paths and laugh out loud. And always remember, a smile is the best medicine. Smile as much as you can. Love, Father Sean."
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Can I ask you to be seated for a few moments, please? We are gathered here in the Friary Church in Rosnaula to say our farewells to a man who was a true giant in his lifetime, Father Sean Gilday. On behalf of all the friars of the province of Ireland and the friars of the custody of the Good Shepherd in Zimbabwe, I want to offer sincere condolences to his family, to his sisters Nancy and Stella, to his brothers Willie, Paddy, Frank and Jimmy, to his sisters-in-law Noreen and Leanne. I want to say a special word of welcome to Willie, who's watching in Roscommon, to Nancy watching in Manchester, and to Paddy watching in New Zealand. And sympathy extends to the wider Gilday family circle, to his many, many friends throughout the world, especially in Zimbabwe, and to the friars here of the community in Rosnaula. When Sean died last Friday morning, he was the oldest member of our province, and yet he remained one of the youngest at heart. Always open to the new, always taking up the challenge of seeing things in a different way. Sean was a gifted and faithful minister of the gospel, whose love of St. Francis and the values of our life infused everything he did. Positivity and enthusiasm were his hallmark. He spoke often of beauty, freedom, and transformation, and his symbol, as Brenda has noted already, was the butterfly. He loved butterflies, and I was quite amused to see last night there are so many butterflies in the floral tributes as well. So Sean is with us still. The people in Zimbabwe who knew and loved Sean refer to him as one who loves the people. And so he did. His knowledge of the Shona language and his understanding of that culture was second to none. Displaying a lot of courage and steadfastness, he remained in what was then Rhodesia all through the liberation struggle, bringing comfort and hope to a people that needed it so much during those years of war. Because of Sean's many fine qualities, it's no wonder that he was elected to lead the friars in Zimbabwe on several occasions. And when the friars in Zimbabwe decided to receive local vocations, it was to Sean they were entrusted as the first novice master. Sean had a great capacity for friendship, and I'm told that he had a wee diary that ensured he never forgot a birthday or anniversary. He was a giver of life and liberty to many people, and his love and respect for people was genuine. Much and all as he loved Zimbabwe, however, he did not want to end his days there, and his health problems in 2003 allowed him to return to Ireland, to Rosnaula, where he could be near the place of his birth and the family he loved so much. He often spoke of Ireland as his place of resurrection. And so it will be as we later this afternoon lay him in the earth from which he came. May his soul rest in peace.
Amen.
And I ask you to stand now as we begin the Mass. On a day like today, we are reminded of our own mortality, of our own need for God, of our own need for God's love. As we prepare to commend Sean to the infinite mercy of our loving God, let us acknowledge our own sinfulness and entrust ourselves once again to that mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to bring us the good news of the Father's love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Jesus, you give us strength for the daily journey of life. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, Good Shepherd, you lead us into the fullness of life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of Sean, your servant and priest, whom you honored with sacred office while he lived in this world, may exult forever in the glorious home of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen.
Children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet appeared. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord. Non siamo. Nuovo più un uomo. Tiene risorse di parlare, di notte rufo, ma non da nasce. Rufo, il riso è buono, il rotore mio, non ci sia mai. Non ci c'è. Non ci
Father Hubert Quinn,
whose brother incidentally was in charge of the airport for years. And someone spade came into the conversation, and after that it was game set and match. So the letters were signed and Sean came to me this year in 1952. So he went through all those years of initiative and making his own profession and doing his studies, and he was ready to move on to the apostolate in 1960. He went down to Africa with Richard Clancy from Cantabitrum, nephew of Richard McBride, and with Miles Austin from Dublin. Sean was a natural extrovert, a people person, and he landed in the land of song, music, dancing, and art and storytelling. Wow, it was bristling with benefit. And he mixed with the people. His great gift was the idea of missionary. He bled and mixed with people, went to the birdrings, did whatever was necessary, and it was a tremendous example of him. Now, I have to go forward quickly, it was 1968. I was out there myself, in a river area called Bumera. It's about 200, quite a few hundred miles south of Capital City. And we had schools and all the rest of it, and one of the schools called Chihara had a big problem. Baru, the elder people, were angry with the headmaster, who was a fine man and knew him well. Anyway, Sean was back in school, so we had to go down and put oil in the troubled waters. Now, I watched sitting inside the classroom as all these parents came in, depositing their axes and bows and arrows and things. Very remote area, and then they got down to the two-hour meeting. It was cut and thrust, no hold for power, and Sean stood there and fielded it all. I was watching, and as I watched, I developed a deep respect for this man, because now I see behind all this song and dance and fellowship and cooperation to a serious and dedicated missionary leader. Because this is the power source to be able to deal with a whole community in that situation. Absolutely. And so I said to myself, he's a leader, he's one of us, he's one with us, and he's the best of us. That's the leader. Now I have to fast forward to 72. He was now the Episcopal Vicar, second to the Archbishop. And this time the government decided to take away the primary school system from the Christian churches, all of them, which had lifted up members of the young country, so to speak. And we had to lose our schools. Now, our schools were integral to our missionary policy. We set up schools where they were needed, brought in the trained teachers, catechists, and got working with people. All that had to go. We were 50 OFMs in the area the size of Leinster, and we had 140 mass centres at that time. What are we to do? So, Father Sean and Father Yuadon went to the University of Rhodesia and studied adult education, and we tried to apply their lessons to the leaders of these communities, because we realized now that we had to stand with the communities and they had to be self-sufficient in every way possible. And so it ended in a whole series of training, skills, identifying gifts of the Holy Spirit, and so forth. There had to be communities who met for prayer and worship, standing together, helping each other, and reaching out to the non-baptized. So that was a number of years of very intense work that came in with that. Sean at the time wrote in a memorandum, "We are meant to relying on the power and the guidance of the Spirit, and like it has been, we like to live joyfully where there are no answers." So he guided us into a new era. That's a very important thing. He was at the beginning of the mission in 1960. Now he's finding things have changed. We have to move. And he was the very man there with wisdom and courage and a positive outlook to help us. And of course, just at that time, in the late 70s, the Liberation War was moving into our area. And of course, it was a guerrilla warfare. And therefore, very ugly on occasion. Now, I want to tell a nice story from that particular area. Have you ever heard the story of the man who goes to the architect with a doorknob and says to the architect, "My wife wants to know when you designed the house to go with this dorm. So Sean actually had such a situation. He had a relation in America. And she sends over some money to be given for a church dedicated to St. Elizabeth. Well, we have such a community in a place called Neurotonga in the O'Hurlick area, where Mr. and Mrs. Baza ran a very nice, cohesive Catholic community. And from working with them, they have gathered, talked, discussed, give out the jobs, make the bricks, carry the sand, and carry the water on their head for 3 miles. There was no water near that place. And that had to be done all the time when the meeting went on. And so in 1973, we dedicated that church, St. Elizabeth, near Clapham. And I have a lovely photograph which shows Sean and Nip of all the happy people, and Mr. Francis Bukowski to his left. Francis Bukowski was a great Catholic lay leader in the church in the 60s and 70s and the 80s. A wonderful man, wherever he was. A man of great respect. So there they were, opening up the new church. And that day also, we put in the Blessed Sacrament into the church, 73. The people could now receive Holy Communion every Sunday when they gathered for a Sunday service. And the priest would only go once a month, because after all, he's looking after County Donegal, and he has to be able to move her out Sunday to that Sunday. Well, it wasn't all, hard work. We often gathered, we had meetings, and we had sing-song. We practiced musicians in our room. We had a band. Anyway, Sean would like to take part, I can assure you. And he was here trying to put more turf on the fire where he had. That was his favorite. And how am I going to plow the rocks above? That was another one. But his pièce de résistance, his parting piece was Danny Kaye had a little song dance routine. Danny Kaye, and it was Carmelita Benita, Di Bolivia Morgan. And Sean would take us off and do a great job dancing and singing, and we always enjoyed it. One of those things you don't get tired of, you know? So that was good fun. On the other side of his life, he's traveling in a bus one day, this called Giambi, and the guerrilla forces stop the bus and say, anybody out? Everybody gets out, and there he is. The children in the United patch, quite running in the bus, but laughing at people. And he's probably going to be shot. People say, hey, easy, that's Father Sean. Oh, easy. So they did, no problem. Sean was a man of warm and deep friendships with many people, but not to mention one which goes with this particular year. He went out in 1960, after he acclimatized the military, sent down 100 miles below the capital city to a place called Endenburg, a small village. That was at the tip of our vast mission area. There came in 1962 a young Englishman who wanted to be a lay missionary with the English Jesuits. I'm sure you've heard of him. His name was John Wellburn. And his great friend was a Father John Love. And they had all been officers in the English Army during the war in Burma and Malaya. And here was John Love to help in 1962. So he came down to stay with Sean for a year. And the two officers, different armies, became fast friends. They really did. And John went on to minister to the lepers, eventually. And in 1978, Sean, who was now our religious superior, went over to a different, with the Jesuit training center, Savarna House, and he met with Father John Love and John Robert, who was down upon his mission. And he presented him with a Franciscan habit as a sign of his great respect. For this great man, John Bradford wore it ever after. You can Google him on the internet and you see there where the Franciscan habit. He got it from Sean. John Bradford was murdered, of course, in 1979 at his job. Now, one day he was speaking to Father Leto Mali, one of our great missionaries, and he said to him, when I come to Africa, I have 3 wishes: to serve lepers, to die as a martyr, to to be buried in the Franciscan habit. Gaily said the match, all took place. It was an extraordinary thing. Now we were called out because next week, around the 18th or so of June, John Barber will be 100 years old. He will be. So Sean will sit catching up with him. So in 1980, Zimbabwe, a new modern African state, was born. The colonial period had passed, and of course that brought all this attendant pressures and thinking laterally and thinking sideways and what we're going to do and keep things going. And so it was a great challenge to the missionaries, and they were trying to there for time. Now in 1983, I'm teaching in Pretoria in the seminary, and the superior of Zimbabwe, Father Pascal Stemmen, he sends a letter down to Father Levi there at the post office in South Africa to say, would you leave that town free? Me. And if you do, we'll be able to free up Sean to begin Franciscan training. Well, we did that. We deserved it, of course, but we did that. And that year, Sean began the pre-novitiate, as it's called. The young men wanted to join up. The Presentation Sisters in Marondera gave us a lovely place to begin with. And so it started. Of course, the pre-novitiate is on to the novitiate. Sean became the novice master. And that eventually he became our religious superior. Now, that again was a turning point. By the way, that was our second effort do training. We had started Father Walters here in Fort Kevin in the 70s, and we had one at least from that period, but then the war came and things fell apart, you know. So we restarted with that year. So I want to say that Sean again, as he was at the beginning of the mission, and during the trouble with the schools, now he's at this very important phase of Franciscan training. And I want to say, he's there fully. He does the heavy lifting every time. He really did. He deserves great credit. Because you know yourself, when you look at a 747 on the tarmac, it looks nice. But getting it up into the sky takes a huge push of energy and power. Takeoff is always the key. So Sean was there at the takeoff, and he stayed to launch for the lesson. Now, Father Lynch mentioned Sean's talking of the place of resurrection. Indeed, I heard him talk about that. And such it was now to him. His contemplative side developed very much here in Moscow, the beauty of the sea and so forth. He went to the hospice in Perth. Father Florian went over to Sligo to see him, to visit him. And they had three precious hours with him, handing over to Stella and the family who came with him. We in Clonmel that day celebrated Mass at 10 o'clock. It was the Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. This is the Friday night. In the first reading, St. Paul says to us, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And when I heard that, I said, that's Sean to be today. A man of the Spirit, a man who is free in himself. I recognize the picture I was given. So we reached communion time in our Mass at our 10:30, and we sang that beautiful hymn, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, and you will find rest for your souls. My yoke is easy, my burden is light. When we come off the altar from Eugene at the text to say that Sean had passed over about 10:30 that morning. It was extraordinary. One of the short words for heaven is, what's a void where the human heart will rest? So Sean rested in the Sacred Heart of Jesus on that morning. And though he continued his journey of transformation, he was deeply into transformation, believing the Holy Spirit transforming us in nature from grub to butterfly. And I was delighted with these beautiful flowers here behind me. And there are all the butterflies on top. That is Sean, the beauty and the transformation. And that was very important for me. Well, today we gather and we pray for him, of course. We thank God for his family, for his his Franciscan family, for his lifelong commission in fruit-bearing service at home and abroad. Yesterday, the swan is silent, and yet his song now begins to break forth.
Thank you.
Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Sean, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory and with him called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Thank you.
wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Francis and Saint Anthony, and all the saints of this constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation and prayer, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith the charge of your Pilgrim Church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and our local Bishop of Hope, the bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the eternity of your Son has came before. Remember your servant, Father Sean, the day when you were called from this world to your Son. Grant that he was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth you would rise up in the flesh, closing of night, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind and goodness to your kingdom. There we go to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall delight in you for all the ages and praise you without end.
Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Coming together as one family of faith, not just here in Rosnaug, but scattered throughout the world, let us now pray together in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
We can't make any physical gesture of a sign of peace in these days, but let us in the depths of our hearts share that peace with one another, especially with those from whom we are somehow distant.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Sean, your servant and priest, that as you have made him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Sean. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual to shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Sean in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Sean in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Sean, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother Sean forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother Sean to his place of rest.
Thank you. Sing Father Sean's favorite hymn. It's the hymn of creation.
I saw the creation. O bizei no kumu kuzana rimi imi mabasa ke ose imi mabasa ke ose imbiwa imambo imi mabasa ose dume zamari imi matenga imbiwa imambo Imi mabasa mambo imbira imambo Mbombi zeino kumunguza narini Imi mabasa keose Sivano mwezi nyenyezi zedenga Imbira imambo mabasa keose Imbira imambo imi mabasa mambo Imbira imambo Mbombi zeino kumukuza nalini, imi mabasa ke ose.
Thank you.